Have you ever watched a superhero movie where the main characters are generating or just straight up blasting each other with energy? And thought to yourself, how the heck do you make that? Well, my friends, have no fear, because today you are gonna learn how to create a dope looking energy effect inside of DaVinci Resolve. But first, if you're new here, my name is Billy Ripka, and I make weekly videos all about teaching you to become a better video editor. So if you want to level up your editing skills, click the subscribe button and the bell notification so you don't miss out on anything. So from a pure creation standpoint, most energy effects are comprised of a lot of the same parts. So we're going to be creating the energy effect from the newer movie that also shares the same title as my life, Chaos Walking. So with that said, let's get into it. So in DaVinci Resolve, we have our footage on our timeline right here, and pretty straightforward, we're just gonna go into Fusion. Do not be scared. I promise you, I'm gonna walk you step by step through this whole thing. So don't fear Fusion. You got this. So now that we're in Fusion, first things first, we need to go ahead and track this lady's face right here, because we're gonna be sticking all that, you know, energy stuff to her face. That sounds gross. So I'm gonna hit Control and Spacebar to pull up the Select Tools menu, and then type in Tracker and just add it in to the flow like this. Move to frame zero, because you don't wanna start tracking halfway through your footage. Then I'm gonna grab the tracker and track her face, and then take this dotted box and make it just a little bit wider. This is called the search area. So ultimately, if the tracker loses her face, it's going to look for her face within that search area. Now, odds are you're not gonna lose her face because she's not moving, but still, good practice. Next, I'm gonna move over to the Operations tab and go under Operation and select Match Move. And then go back to the Trackers tab, and under Adaptive Mode, we're gonna select Best Match. And then under Match Tolerance, I'm gonna move it down a bit. And now we're gonna hit Track Forward from Current Time and let DaVinci Resolve do its thing. So once DaVinci is done tracking this lady's face, we're gonna go ahead and grab our energy burst. Now this is actually from the Energy Burst collection by Action VFX. Now it really is a great collection, so I'll drop the link in the description. Also, if you do use the code BILLY10, it'll give you 10% off the whole pack. Full disclaimer, we do get a small percentage of the sale, but this just helps to support the channel and give us the ability to keep creating content like this on YouTube. However, if you do want a free version of this, Action VFX was nice enough to actually provide a low resolution version for free. So that'll also be down below. Anyway, I'm gonna drag the energy burst onto the graph right here and go ahead and hit F2 to rename it. Now I'm going to grab the output of the energy burst and connect it to the output of the tracker. And this will merge it right in with everything else. Next, go ahead and grab a transform node and add it after the energy burst right here. And then in the Inspector tab, under Center, right click and go to Connect To, and then under the Tracker 1 Tracker Path, click Position right here. What this is doing is it's connecting the tracking data to a parameter. And then you'll see that our energy asset is tracked to her face. So now we need to actually apply that tracking data to the energy right here. I'm gonna go ahead and actually rename this transform. Then I'm gonna grab another transform node and put it after the X form tracker. And under pivot, I'm gonna move it up. Then I'm just gonna grab the X and put it over her face, like the center of her face. So now when I move this size up to 1.88, I guess, it's gonna actually stay centered on her face and not be thrown out of alignment. So now once we got that, we're gonna go ahead and hit Control Spacebar again and type in color curves, and then add it in after the energy 6 right here. Then I'm gonna add a few points on the curve and bring it down just a bit. Now let's add some color. So pull up the Select Tools menu again, add in the color corrector node, and then add whatever color you want. I really like this purple look right here. So now, because it's super strong, I'm gonna click on the Merge 1 node, and under Blend, I'm gonna bring it down to 0.25. Now let's make it glow. So type in glow, grab this node right here and add it in after this transform, then bring down the glow size to 1.7 and bring up the glow to 0.85, and under apply mode, switch it from normal to threshold. Now make it a double glow and duplicate this glow node by hitting Control C and then Control V and just paste it under the original. Then what we're gonna do this time under glow size, we're gonna bring it up to about 20 and then bring the glow down to 0.8. Then make it a triple glow and duplicate it one more time and then bring the glow down to 0.57. That's it, triple glow is enough, okay? It's gonna look dope though. Also, if you're getting value from this, a like and possibly even a subscribe would totally be amazing. So thanks guys. So we need to sell this effect, and one way to do that is actually by adding some displacement. Displacement, when done correctly, actually is gonna help sell the effect of this energy in the air by displacing some of the background. So add in the displacement node after tracker one, and then grab output from transform one and connect it to the green output of the displace one. I'm just gonna add a pipe router, which literally does nothing else but help to keep everything organized. So to do that, all you're gonna do is hold Alt on your keyboard and click on the place you want to add a pipe router. So in the displace node, we're gonna apply the tracking data to the center X and Y, just like we did earlier. And then we'll change the refraction channel from Luma to Alpha. And under refraction strength, I'm gonna move it up from 0.1 to 0.2. So that you can get a better idea of what the displacement is doing, I'm gonna click on the node and then hit 2 on my keyboard to put it in the viewer. And you can see that it's actually creating these like waves from the energy effect, but it's a little too aggressive. We don't want that kind of like sharp displacement. To fix that, we're gonna increase the spread, and that's gonna give it more of this like wavy kind of look coming from the displacement. But it's also displacing her face like everywhere. So to fix this, we actually have to subtract her face from the rest of all of it. Just, I'll show you how to do it, okay? So what you're gonna do is copy the transform tracker and paste it below this merge one node right here. And then I'm gonna grab an ellipse mask and connect it to the yellow output of the transform tracker. Now connect the output of the transform node to the blue triangle on merge one. Then I'm gonna make the circle a lot smaller and have it just be around her face like this. And so she stops looking like a grape. I'm just gonna hit invert, and then I'm going to bring up the softness to about 0.9. Now all this did right here was subtract the actual energy effect from around her face. Now to remove the displacement from her face, it's gonna be a little bit different, because if we connect the transform tracker to the alpha output on displace one, it's actually gonna create this like weird doubling effect. So what we have to do instead is add in a transform node after the pipe router right here. Then I'll just connect the output of the transform tracker to the blue triangle on the transform two and just use a pipe router to make it look all pretty and stuff. You know how it is. Now just click on transform two and go to the settings tab right here and select multiply by mask. And this right here is going to actually subtract the displacement from her face. Next, let's add a bit of blur and distortion into our energy asset. To do that, you're gonna add in vector distortion and drag it in after the displace one node, and that made a mess. But hold on, we could fix it, don't freak out. You're gonna grab the output of the last glow node and bring it to the green triangle on the vector distort. So now instead of the whole image being distorted, it's just the energy effect. And then we're gonna actually subtract her face from the distortion so that you can actually see her face. So just connect the output of the transform tracker to the blue triangle under vector distortion, and then we'll be able to actually see her again, because at that point it just looked like somebody tried to erase her face. All right, so we are almost there. In the vector distortion, we're gonna change our X channel to blue and keep our Y channel to red. And then under scale, I'm gonna bring that all the way down to like 0.1, because that's a lot of distortion. Now deselect lock bias X and Y, then move the X and Y bias to 0. So now we are finally onto the flicker effect that you see within the movie. So to do this, it's actually gonna be pretty simple. What we're gonna do is click on the merge one node and then go down to blend, then right click and click on expression. And I'm just gonna round this down to 0.25 because it's gonna make it a bit easier. And then I'm just gonna copy this expression that someone by the name of Blackbird Calls Sue was nice enough to actually make for me, because they're way smarter than I am in this area of expressions and mathematics and all of that stuff. So you really came in clutch. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. Anyways, because I don't want it to get brighter than 0.25, I'm gonna add in a multiplication sign after this, and then I'm just gonna paste in the expression. Now, if you don't put your max number in and multiply it by the expression, like I did here, it's gonna instantly go all the way to full brightness, and you're not gonna have a cool looking effect. It's gonna look super weird and bright and awful, so don't do that. Now, one thing to note with this expression is that it is specific for your frame rate. So if you're rocking 60 frames a second, you're gonna have to change one of the numbers up. So in the description, I'll explain more of how to do this, and I'll even explain how to like make it flicker faster or slower. I got you, boo. Anyways, we also want to add the flicker on the displace node. So right click on refraction strength and go down to expression. And once again, add the multiplication sign after our max number, which was what we had before, and then just paste the expression. And don't be afraid, you can totally change your max number out. It's not an issue, just play around with it, okay? It's not permanent. So last step in all of this is to go down to the transform tracker and go over to the settings tab, and then just bring down the blend a bit so that we have some distortion on her face, because you'd have some there, but just not an overwhelming amount of it. And speaking of overwhelming, this has been a lot, but you know what won't be hard now? To add more energy effects and colors. It's gonna be a cakewalk now. All you'll do is drag in whatever energy burst you want, then just duplicate the color curves and the color corrector and connect it with your energy burst. Then all you're gonna do after that is grab the output from the color corrector and connect it to the other color corrector to merge it in. Now you can just change the color, which means you'll have now two colors, and it's gonna look even cooler. You may have to bring down the blend just a little, but in general, it's gonna look pretty dope. Now we've been working on some huge things behind the scenes here, and so big that I can't actually tell you just yet. It's like two or three big things, and next week you're gonna actually be able to hear more about one of them, so stay tuned for that. But if you want more videos like this, click on the top for a video with all of my DaVinci Resolve tutorials, or click on the bottom for a video that YouTube thinks that you would like. But until the next one, peace.